Welcome back to second session of chapter 2, that is accounting for partnership firm fundamentals. In this session, we will be doing some practical problems. Let's go straight to question number 12. X and Y started business on 1st April 2013 with capitals of rupees 3 lakhs and 1,80,000 respectively. On 1st May, X introduced an additional capital of rupees 60,000 and Y withdrew rupees 30,000 from his capital. On 1st October, X withdrew rupees 1,20,000 from his capital and Y introduced rupees 1,50,000. Interest on capital is allowed at 6% per annum. Calculate the interest on capital for the year ended 31st March 2014. So, it is very important for commerce students to understand the question before you quickly go into solution. So, in this question, we can ascertain many things. First, that is, the trading period of this firm starts from 1st April to 31st March in the next year. So, when you go through this question, on 1st May, X introduced additional capital of 60,000, and on the same day, Y also withdrew 30,000 from his capital. On the same day, that is, right after starting the business, it was this transaction took place or this incident took place in the next month. That you should keep in mind. Next is on 1st October, that is, in the month of October, X withdrew 1,20,000 from his capital. X has withdrawn 1,20,000 from his capital and Y introduced 1,50,000 on 1st October 2013. So, there are three instances. Let's see the solution here for this question. That is, we are going to calculate only the interest on capital. So, interest on opening capital. The opening capital of the partners were 3 lakhs and 1,80,000. And the last sentence clearly states that the interest on capital is given at 6% per annum, which means 6% of 3 lakhs comes to 18,000 for X and 1,80,000 at the rate of 6% comes to 10,800 for partner Y. That is the first, that is the seed capital, seed money that has been invested in by the X and Y in a partnership firm. Next is add. You have to add in P, that is interest on additional capital. As I've explained the question, there is an additional capital that has been introduced by X and Y in the middle of the year and in the beginning of the year, after 1 month. That means X has introduced 60,000 in the month of October. So if you calculate the months from October till 31st March, it comes to 11 months. No. I'm sorry. 60,000 in the month of May. In the month of May. That is 1st May. On 1st May, X have introduced 60,000. So from May till 31st March next year, it comes to 11 months. So it is, the rate is same. So 60,000 into 6 by 100 into 11 months by 12, that is 1 year, it comes to 3,300. Next is Y. Y have introduced 1,50,000. So Y have introduced 1,50,000 in the month of October. That is from October till 31st March 2014, it comes to 6 months. So the rate is 6. Therefore, X additional interest on X additional capital is 1,50,000 into 6 by 100 into 6 by 12. It comes to 4,500. That is interest on additional capital. Less interest on capital withdrawn. That is the capital that has been withdrawn. As I've told you, drawings, it can be called as a drawings. There was a drawings of 1,20,000 for X and 30,000 by Y. So, if X have withdrawn, 1,20,000 in on 1st October, it comes to 6 months till 31st March 2014. So the rate of interest is 6. Therefore, the amount comes to 3,600 for withdrawing the money. I'm putting this in a bracket, which indicates it is an amount to be deducted. So, for Y, that is 30,000. Y has withdrawn 30,000 from his capital. That is, for it was done in the month of May. Therefore, it comes to 11 months. That is 30,000 into 6 by 100 into 11 months by 1 year. That is 12 months. It comes to 1,650. Therefore, the total amount for the interest on capital is 17,700 for X and 13,650 for Y. This is your interest on capital for X and Y. Next, let's go to question number 14. On 31st March 2014, after the close of the accounts, the capital accounts of X and Y stood in the books of the firm at 2,40,000 and 3 lakhs respectively. On 1st May 2013, X introduced an additional capital of 60,000 and Y withdrew rupees 30,000 from his capital. On 1st October 2013, X withdrew rupees 1,20,000 from his capital and Y introduced rupees 1,50,000. Interest on capital is allowed at 6% per annum. Subsequently, it was discovered that interest on capital at 6% per annum had been omitted. The profits for the year ended 31st March 2014 amounted to 1,20,000 and the partners' drawings had been X 60,000, Y 30,000. The profit sharing ratio of X and Y was 3:2. That means this question is similar to question number 12, but there is some additional problem here. That is, the profit for the year, is 1,20,000. So they have omitted, they have forgotten to provide interest on capital at the rate of 6% per annum. I'm sorry to mention here that you are also required to calculate the interest on capitals, A fixed and B is fluctuating. So we have two cases here. Let's go here in the solution. That is case A, if capitals are fixed. First problem is if capitals are fixed. So if capitals are fixed, we have closing capital. That is given in a question that after the closing of their capitals, the capitals of the firm stood at 2,40,000 and 3 lakhs. So this is an opening closing capital. Closing capital is 2,40,000 for X and 3 lakhs for Y. There was a withdrawal of 7 amount by the partners from their capital. So we will have to add that because it is a fixed capital account. Therefore, we will have to add the withdrawal that has been made by the partners. That is, withdrawal made by X is 1,20,000 and Y is 30,000. We will have to add this because the capital amount has to remain fixed we should not deduct this because the capitals are fixed. You should remember that. Less additional capital. So whether there is an additional capital or whatever, the capital is fixed. So they cannot add this. So we will have to deduct the additional capital that has been introduced by the partners in the middle of the year. Therefore, the fixed capital amounts to 3 lakhs and 1,80,000 for X and Y respectively. So opening capital comes to A plus B minus C, which means the closing capital plus withdrawal of capital, even if they withdraw, it has to be re-added because the capital is supposed to be fixed. And additional capital, even if they introduce in the middle of the year, it has to be deducted because the capitals are fixed. You should remember that. From here, we will have to calculate what is the interest of the capital. So, interest on opening capital. This is an opening capital for X. So, X has 3 lakhs and at the rate of 6%. So, his interest on capital, on opening capital, is 18,000 at the rate of 6%. Y has 1,80,000 as opening capital at the rate of 6%. So, his interest on capital is 10,800. Next, B, you will have to add interest on additional capital. That is 60,000 into 6 by 100 into 11 months by 1 year, 12 months. It comes to 3,300. And for Y, for additional capital interest, 1,50,000 into 6 by 100 into 6 months by 1 year, that is 12 months, it comes to 4,500. Again, you will have to deduct the interest on capital that has been withdrawn. The capital that has been withdrawn by the partners are not supposed to be given interest because it is not used by the partnership firm. So, interest on capital withdrawn is 1,20,000 for X at the rate of 6% for 6 months, that is 3,600. And also for Y, it is 30,000 into 6 by 100 into 11 months by 12. 1,650. Therefore, the net amount for interest on capital for X is 17,700 and also for Y is 13,650. So you should remember in this portion that the interest on opening capital has been provided. So interest on additional capital has been provided, but interest on capital withdrawn, that is when people have withdrawn the money from the firm, interest is not supposed to be provided. If you provide, it will be a loss to the firm. Let's go to case B. Case B is related with if capitals are fluctuating. This is just the opposite of the problem, that is case A. So under this problem, calculation of opening capital. We will have to calculate the opening capital to provide interest on capital. Closing capital is 2,40,000 and 3 lakhs respectively. Withdrawal at withdrawal of capital 1,20,000 and 30,000. And at drawings. Drawings were 60,000 and 30,000 for personal use. Less additional capital, that is 60,000 and 1,50,000. Share of profits 70,000 and 48,000. When you look at this solution, from here, this drawing is added. Drawing is added, and additional capital and share of profits are not added because this will go to the guardian accounts of the partner and not under the capital accounts of a partner. Therefore, these are deducted. So, opening capital for X and Y is A plus B plus C minus E and D and E. That means opening capital of a partner X is 2,88,000 and Y is 1,62,000. So, this is an opening capital for partners. Therefore, out of this, we will have to calculate interest on capitals. So interest on opening capital is 2,88,000, that is opening capital of a partner, into 6,500 at the rate of 6%, 17,280 and 9,720 for X and Y. And interest on additional capital, add. You will have to add this interest on additional capital, that is 60,000 into 6,500 into 11 months by 1 year, 12 months, that's 3,300. And Y, 1,50,000 into 6,500 into 6 months by 12, that is 4,500. Less C, interest on capital withdrawn. So 1,20,000 into 6,500 into 11 months by 12 months. Then for Y, 30,000 into 6,500 into 6 by 12, that is for 6 months. So it comes to 3,600 and 1,650, which means in this problem also, the interest on opening capital is provided, and also interest on additional capital has been provided, but the interest on capital withdrawn is not provided. So as I've told you, you are not supposed to provide interest on capital because this money has been withdrawn. It is not used by the partnership firm. Therefore, they are not supposed to pay for the money that they haven't used. So the net amount for interest on capital comes to 16,980 and 12,570. So in this two problem, we have already come across how to provide interest on capital, how to calculate fixed capital account and also a fluctuating capital account. So to calculate this, knowing the provision that has been given in a Partnership Act 1932, maybe it may be mentioned in a partnership deed or it may not be mentioned in a partnership deed. So you should reflect back to the provisions, some of the provisions that has been given in a partnership deed. At the same time, you are also supposed to know when was the capital being introduced and how this drawing was made, on which date. So you will have to ascertain the number of years, the number of months, and also the rate of interest. Therefore, if you don't know all these things, you will not be able to calculate this. But you, after ascertaining the number of months and the date of withdrawal or date of introduction, the rate of interest, you are supposed to calculate this solution. With this, we have come to the end of the session. In the next session, again, I'll be showing some of the practical problems. Thank you.